Now my decision is this, that the Quran told a historical lie about a guy called Jesus that was well known in the era where he was known. Now there was no way that 12 guys that spent 3.5 years with Jesus would mistake him for someone else. That's nonsense.
I want to know how many of the disciples.
No, no, but I want to know why.
Yeah, what's the comment?
No, it makes sense.
No, because why does it make sense?
Yeah, why,
no, because,
why not?
It
because,
the,
because, the message. Because it's wait, not, because it's Jesus not, it's the not message. Stipulated that these are the witnesses that's going to prove everything to be true.
Yeah,
no,
so
right.
You're making up a question that doesn't.
Yeah, that's what happens. Let's establish that we've identified four witnesses. We've identified four witnesses so far.
Four.
There's more.
Only four.
Three witnesses.
Me, Jesus.
Only four. He hasn't got
listen,
one.
Listen.
Only four.
Listen.
Only four.
Yes.
And you don't have
yes.
one.
Yes.
I want
there's
from
no
this man. Let's show him for the liar that he is.
Talk to me.
It's the second time now. We're going to show you for the liar that you are.
Sister,
I want.
You want to help him.
I want.
Your
Torah.
Bible says.
I want.
There is no witness.
He can't answer the question. He can't defend the Quran. He can't defend the lie.
Listen.
So he.
Where he talked about the crucifixion. He said that Jesus didn't die. Yeah? He said that, and I'm paraphrasing here now. No, he said that Jesus didn't die. No, no, Surah 4, he said that Jesus didn't die. That somebody else was on the cross, yeah?
You? No.
Yes, it does.
You, the one like you, yeah? They make him brainwash of people. They come here like this. He's coming to educate.
It said that Jesus didn't die and they didn't crucify him, but he only appeared to themselves.
So not someone else.
There's a million.
He wasn't someone else. You said he was someone else.
I'm quoting. I'm paraphrasing. He said that they killed him not. Neither did they crucify him. I'm paraphrasing here now. So don't take word for word.
You're paraphrasing. I don't know the verse.
Okay.
So neither. So look. Can we agree that none of us know this verse?
Yeah, no, I know the verse.
When did I say I was a Muslim?
Okay. Right. The Quran it says. That Jesus didn't die. No, I'm paraphrasing. I will paraphrase. It says that Jesus didn't die. This is the crux. It doesn't matter about the words. It's saying that Jesus didn't die and it only appeared that he had died when in fact he hadn't died. And it also said,
you know,
what, that Jesus didn't die? What are you talking about? Do you actually know what I believe?
Don't Christians think that Jesus didn't die?
No, they say that Jesus died and rose again.
And he will return.
No, my friend, you got it completely wrong. It's saying that Jesus died on the cross, was put in the ground, and rose again. Not that he didn't die, he rose again, and then he's coming back. But the Quran is saying, that, yes, now, but he died, and now he's back alive. But the Quran is saying, my friend, stop playing games. You know what I mean? The Quran, my friend, the fact that you haven't read it,
he rose again, and he'll come back.
My friend, stop. The fact that you haven't read it, I shouldn't even be taking you seriously. Because you're arguing about something you haven't read. This is actually insane. You're arguing with me about something you haven't read. What's wrong with getting it up on your phone? You don't want to get it up. Get it up.
You said you were perfect.
My friend, get it up on your phone, please.
Do you know it or not?
I'm asking you nicely. Get it on your phone.
Do you know it or not?
Let's expose falsehood. Get it on your phone. Surah 4:157. And I'll continue to paraphrase. And then you get me word for word. It said that Jesus didn't die. They killed him not, and neither did they crucify him. And those that say otherwise have no certain knowledge. They killed him not. So in essence, it's saying that Jesus didn't die on the cross. He didn't die. But somebody died. It's establishing that somebody was there dying. But the person that was there dying wasn't Jesus. So we have two things. We have the denial of Jesus dying, but that somebody else died in his place. And it talks about appearance. It only appeared to them so. Now my question, I have a couple of questions. There's a million questions actually in there. But my first one is, what caused the appearance? Jesus was a well-known guy, yeah? Jesus was a well-known prophet, a well-known man in that era of town. What could have happened to make people think that the guy that's well-known was actually someone else? It's like seeing me.
Miracles.
No, 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 no. It doesn't say that. Let's just deal with what it says.
Yes, it does.
It said it only appeared. It doesn't use the word miracle. Not in Torah.
Not in that specific verse.
What you haven't read. Why don't you get it out?
I've read the Quran.
Why don't you get the Quran? My friend, I'm asking him in front of the camera to get up Surah 4, 157, and he will not do it. This is a serious subject.
I've taken it.
That's where the Quran stands. The Quran stands. This is the crux. Surah 157. I would like you to read it. Read Surah 4, chapter 4, 157.
And what are you saying? What are you saying it says?
It's saying that Jesus didn't die.
Why don't you show us where the Jesus said, I'm God, worship me?
Show me where Muhammad said he was a prophet. Show me where Muhammad said he was a prophet.
What did we show you?
Show me where Muhammad
showed you.
I'm only interested in what Muhammad said. What is lie?
Muhammad didn't say that. I'm talking about Muhammad. You see the difference between them? I'm asking her to show me the words of Muhammad, and she's showing me the words of Allah.
Right. What she's saying.
So now, I'm going to deal with that again because I dealt with it before, and I'm going to deal with it again. It's what you call word for word citation.
What did Jesus say? I'm God.
And I am asking the Muslims likewise to show me where Muhammad said he was a prophet. Where did Muhammad himself, not Allah, where did Muhammad say I am a prophet? It's the same thing. The question that you are asking me, where did Jesus say I am God? The equivalent is where did Muhammad say he was a prophet?
So we can't. In my mind,
what I'm asking you, my friend, is to read the Quran first. Because you haven't. You don't know Surah 157. You don't know Surah 157.
Look, we never talk. She never talked to you. Look, nobody talked to you about Quran. Nobody talked to you. I just gave you an example. When you come here and talk.
Right, what I'm saying, ladies and gentlemen, is the Quran is denying an historical fact. It's denying an historical fact. Now, if you put aside the Bible and you put aside the Quran, we can establish. Friend, if you put aside the Bible and we put aside the Quran, can we or can we not establish whether Jesus was crucified? Without the Bible and without the Quran, what is being said? Who else is saying something?
All right. I'm saying this. Are you going to tell me Jesus, he got crossed for me?
I'm not telling you that. I'm saying that if you put aside the Bible, I'll say it again. If you put aside the Bible and you put aside the Quran,
Jesus, he was a human.
This is what I'm saying. I'm saying if
he was eating with people.
Can I answer? Can I answer?
If he don't eat and drink, he's gonna die. That's why he was eating and drinking.
Okay, can I answer?
If not, he's a human. He's gonna die.
Can I respond? I'm saying if you put aside the Quran and put aside the Bible, we can establish that Jesus was crucified.
You lost me.
We can establish that without the Bible and without the Quran. So the Quran is lying. The Quran has told a historical lie.
Not eat food.
And
if
not
you
only
don't
has
eat
it
food, and it, you should die.
It told an historical lie.
He was eating food, he was drinking.
My friend, that's an ad hominem. Like that's an ad hominem. You're not dealing with the issue. The issue is about the crucifixion. Now, without the Bible and the Quran, history tells us that Jesus died. Jesus was crucified. The Quran, 600 years later, let's establish when this is happening. A bunch of guys came along 600 years later and said that the eyewitnesses were wrong. Now, let's use a bit of logic. If the eyewitnesses were wrong, if the people that lived with Jesus were wrong, then let's all go home. I'm not going to listen to people that came 600 years later. So if we can establish, if we can establish that the eyewitnesses are wrong, then we need to go home and forget the Quran. Because if the eyewitnesses are wrong,
guy that turned up
600 years later are wrong. What I'm saying to you, my friend, is the Quran that claims to be the word of God. Without error, imperfection, without flaw, I told a lie, a blatant historical lie about a man that was well known in an area where he was well known.
How do you go about the subject when they say, but he's someone on the cross that looks like God?
Give me a name. Who was the person that looked so much like Jesus that the eyewitnesses didn't know? It's about Anthony confusing you. I think Anthony would know you now anywhere he sees you. So if some other guy got slapped, Anthony wouldn't say that. So what's your name? Anthony wouldn't say that. Anthony would know it wasn't you, regardless of the similarities. When you know someone, you know someone.
Or I can take a better example. Maybe somebody that knows you better than anybody.
Forget him.
You know, no, he's a part of him. No, my friend.
Forget him. Jesus is God.
You know people that know you better than God. And you know they wouldn't confuse you with someone else, regardless of the similarity. And that's what's happening here. The Quran is having me believe that a guy called Jesus, who was a prophet, who was well known in that area where he was mistaken. So when the 12 eyewitnesses who hanged around with him for 3 years saw him being crucified, it wasn't really him, but they said, oh, Jesus is being crucified. Now, let's deal with the deception. Yes. Now let's deal with it. Let's deal with it. It says the Quran said that it only appeared. So now let's talk about the appearance. Let's talk about what caused. No, my friend, listen to what I'm saying. What caused it to appear? What caused it to appear that Jesus was being crucified when it wasn't actually him being crucified? Would you like to answer that? What happened to make it look like it was Jesus being crucified when it wasn't actually him, amongst people that knew him very well? If it wasn't Jesus, those who were there would know that wasn't Jesus. And there's a bigger problem than that. It's one of deception. There's a bigger problem than that. There's a bigger problem. No, 1 second. Let's stop a second. There's a bigger
problem. Another person appeared.
What's the name? What's the name?
It was a person appeared to him.
What's the name? What's the name of that person?
He was a pilot.
What's the name?
Lazarus.
What do you mean?
Where's the evidence? Where's the evidence that it was Lazarus? That the Quran. Let the Quran say it was Lazarus. No, I'm talking about the Quran. Does the Quran say that it was
Don't worry about the Quran.
Right.
Look,
I'm talking about the Quran, my friend. Right.
You said God lied. You have to prove it to us.
Does the Quran say it was Lazarus?
It's up to you to study.
I have studied.
And make your own decision.
Right. Okay, right. Thank you very much. Right, thank you very much. Now, my decision is this, that the Quran told a historical lie about a guy called Jesus that was well known in the era where he was known. Now, there was no way that 12 guys that spent 3.5 years with Jesus would mistake him for someone else. That's nonsense. That is nonsense.
Quran did not. 1 minute. Quran did not tell a lie, and it did not tell the truth.
So where would
it just told you what has not happened?
No, it's a lie. But it's a lie, my friend.
Let's not.
And the Quran is saying that he wasn't crucified, and someone else was crucified in his place. Do you see how many problems there are with this?
You know, the Bible. You can make Bible on your own.
No,
but the Quran,
no,
you cannot.
No.
Make
Quran. So let me ask you a question, young lady. Let me ask you a question. Was Jesus crucified? Was Isa crucified? Did he die on the cross? She doesn't know what I mean. Right. What I'm saying is this. Jesus was well known. There was no way he would be mistaken. So you said I can come to my...
It doesn't matter.
Okay. It matters very much. Because the Christian faith is based
on the Bible.
We're dealing with the Quran. They don't want to deal with the Quran. We're going to deal with the Quran. Surah 517, I told a lie and you cannot get away with that lie. You have told a lie and you cannot get away with that lie. And you also said, so also let's talk about the appearance now. It said it wasn't Jesus is what it's saying, but it only appeared that it was Jesus. Now question, what caused the appearance? What caused it to look like it was Jesus? My friend,
okay, one minute.
Answer my question. What's my question?
It's not what caused the action.
No, appearance.
What caused the event.
My friend, it says it only appeared to them so. So what made it appear to them so?
it implies that it was, it doesn't say that strictly, because, but it sounds like it was Allah.
Because
it sounds very much.
Because it was a scripture.
Now let's be clear.
And the scripture is the birth of the
creator. Let's be clear though, you said that I'm not saying that it was Allah necessarily at this moment, but I'm saying there's a strong implication that it was Allah that called the appearance. If I'm wrong, correct me.
Everything,
and if you're saying I'm wrong,
everything.
Okay, so correct me.
All happenings,
so
all events.
What called the appearance? What called the appearance that it was, that it looked like Jesus but it wasn't him? What called
it
the appearance?
It was Jesus on the cross.
It was?
It was according to the scripture.
Which scripture?
The scripture that he was to fulfill, that he was seemingly to be crucified.
What scripture is that?
Probably a scripture taken from a true story.
What story? What book?
Probably a
what
true
book?
Story that was
my friend
earlier.
You're catching at straws. It's the Quran. The Quran said it appeared to themselves. You seem to be ashamed. The Quran said it appeared to themselves. I have to conclude that Allah called the appearance unless you tell me the other way.
Who knows better?
Right.
You know better,
okay.
Or Allah knows better?
So,
if Allah tells you it was not crucified,
now let's get
crucified.
Some context. Let's get some context. The context is 600 years later. 600 years later, somebody comes and says that Jesus wasn't crucified against the evidence that existed before. That's a lie, unless you prove otherwise. Because how can somebody that's 600 years late know better than those who were there at the time?
He never told you he was crucified anyway. It's you people who's going around
and
saying
he was testimony.
He told you he was crucified according to the scripture.
We have the testimony of the 12 apostles. Yeah? They said all throughout the Bible, we are eyewitnesses. So basically, they hanged around with Jesus. They were his mates. They said, we are eyewitnesses of these things. We saw him, and we actually, even after the resurrection, Jesus came back. After Jesus had died,
Let me finish. You never finished. You've been there 5 hours. You never finished 1 second.
But you got to, my friend, you got to make some valid points. Because you're not answering any of my questions.
We get chair.
No, but hold on.
Chair. You sit here for a bit.
But you've got to make some valid points. I'm asking you very specifically.
I'm going to prove to you how accurate the Quran is. Because for 600 years you become believers that Jesus was crucified on the cross. Allah put you right by saying you were wrong. It was not crucified, nor was it dead.
Let's establish some ground rules.
You have to take that for value.
Let's establish some ground rules a bit. I don't want you to teach me the whole history of Islam. I'm not interested. I will fall asleep right now. What I want you to tell me, I want to deal with specifics. Don't teach me the whole of Islam and tell me about the five pillars. I don't want to hear that. I know that. I know the history of Islam. I know what Islam means. I know what Muslim means. I know what it means.
I know what you
right,
know.
So
and
I don't want
you
to teach
arguing,
me history. I want you to teach me from Surah 415. I want some historical verification of Surah 415. And I'll tell you why.
Did I say I'm a practicing Muslim?
I'll tell you why.
Did I say I'm a practicing
Muslim?
Because
that's where we hang in between the balance of Islam. Quite simply, Paul, the apostle, said that the crucifixion hangs on this. He said, if Jesus didn't die, your faith is in vain. So if Jesus didn't die, if Jesus wasn't crucified and resurrected, my faith is in vain.
It is in vain. That's where the whole argument is about.
Likewise, if Surah 4157 is a lie, as I believe it is, then your faith is in vain. So let's get a balance. Let's not just say,
about my name one more time.
What I'm saying is, if Surah, Paul said, let's be clear, that the crucifixion and the resurrection, that's what the Christian faith hangs on. And if it's not true, Paul says, the faith is in vain. So
it
I'm
is
waiting.
In vain.
Let
is
me
in vain.
Finish. Right, I don't yeah. I know you to finish at a good point. If that's wrong, my faith is in vain. However, if Surah 4157
is
wrong, your faith is in vain. So now we've got to get a balance. Now we've got to get a balance. And the balance is this. I want you to tell me how somebody that wasn't there at the time could have this information about Jesus 600 years later.
Because there is one God and the inspiration is from that one God. Whether it's Jesus, whether it's Prophet Muhammad, But there is Abraham, Moses, David, whatever. That inspiration is from one and only God.
What about dealing with the crucifixion?
Which one God?
I'm dealing with the crucifixion.
Which one God?
But don't give me a history of Islam, please. Don't give me a history of Islam. You are.
Islam.
I want you to answer.
No.
It's Surah. I want you to verify. I need some verification, my friend. This is serious. The Surah 157. It's made a very specific claim. Let's pretend it's not. It said that Jesus didn't die. That's what it's saying.
The problem we have here is Islam comprehends Christianity.
Why are you wearing my hat?
And captures.
Why are you wearing Christianity?
Cannot comprehend Islam. You know, it's good, you're trying, but you need to try to listen more and talk less.
My friend, I studied it. You can't keep saying that. Muslims can't keep saying that and getting away with it. Listen, week in and week...
There's no such thing as Muslims.
Right, let's deal with this. Muslims... Okay, I want to be very... Okay, I want to be very clear. You're accusing me of being ignorant. This is a tactic that Muslims use all the time. You pretend that Christians haven't read the Quran.
Whereas, not comprehend Quran.
My friend,
he read it. Show us what you read in the Quran.
Okay, right. I'm dealing with it again. Surah 157, and that's all I'm dealing with.
Failed, yeah.
I'm dealing with Surah 157. That's all. Yeah. I don't nothing else. Nothing else. I will ignore anything else. It says that it's saying they crucified him not. Neither did they kill him. That's what it's saying. Yeah. And those I'm paraphrasing here now. Those that say otherwise. Yeah. It only appeared to themselves. And those that say otherwise don't know what they're talking about. I'm paraphrasing. That's what he's saying. The essence of that verse is saying that Jesus didn't die. And if anybody says otherwise, they have no knowledge of the facts. Right. Now, verification. The context, first and foremost, is 600 years. Some people have turned up on the scene 600 years after the fact and said that the fact didn't happen. I need some verification for this. What do they know?
Yeah, but
who are the eyewitnesses?
Oh dear, there wasn't no eyewitness.
Right, no.
The Bible tells
my
you.
My friend, don't change this. I spoke to you before, and what you did last time is not going to work this time.
Oh, is it?
I spoke
oh,
to this
it?
Guy before,
running away
and I know his tactics. I know his tactics, and this time they're not working. This time, your tactics. You're on YouTube, my friend, playing tricks.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
What trick did I play?
You're on
what
you call it.
What trick did I play?
Right,
I expose you. That's all.
You're right, okay, right. Okay, here goes
your truth.
Right, what I'm saying in a nutshell, Surah 157 is a lie. And until this point, you haven't proved me wrong.
Right,
it's
okay.
A lie.
No.
Some guys have turned up 600 years later and then lied thereafter.
No, it wasn't 600
years.
And
they're lying.
Okay,
and they're lying.
It wasn't
600 year gap.
Okay,
in
it wasn't 600 years. Get your fact right.
Let me be clear about what I mean. See, look at it. Right, okay.
If
you're going to do that, I'm going to turn away.
All right, clear.
Okay, I'm going to turn away.
You say you're going to clear it.
Right, okay, right.
Clear it.
What I'm saying is, Muhammad, Islam came 600 years after the Bible. 600 years after the Bible. So if somebody came 600 years after saying that the people on the scene were wrong.
But you see, this is where you're getting it wrong. Because
you are saying they were wrong.
Because the Lord,
you're
the Lord
they were
that
wrong.
Sent Jesus is the same Lord that
no,
sent
Muhammad. No.
Therefore, he's telling you, he's telling you you're wrong.
And I'm saying, listen to what I'm saying.
Yes, he's telling you you're wrong.
Right, now listen to what I'm saying.
Exactly.
I'm saying that's hocus pocus garbage.
Well, that's
right.
What you
said. And
if it's hocus
let me
pocus
finish.
Garbage,
let me
show you how hocus
let
pocus.
Let me finish.
Look, you always want to finish. You don't let people finish. Let me finish.
Stick on the subject.
Let me finish. If you talk,
I'm dealing with Surah 157.
Yes,
explain it to me.
I will stick to it.
With the historical evidence.
I will stick to it. Your Bible says.
I want it. I'm dealing with the Quran. I want historical evidence.
Your Bible says.
I want historical evidence for Surah 157. I want from this man historical evidence. I want from this man. Let's show him for the liar that he is.
Talk to me.
It's the second time now. We're going
to
show you for the liar that you are. I want.
You want to help him?
I want
your Bible says.
I want
there is no witness.
He can't answer the question. He can't defend the Quran. He can't defend the lie. So he's diverting.
Right.
Surah 157.
Yes.
157 said that Jesus didn't die. And if you put aside, no, because you're not dealing with the subject. If you put aside the Quran and you put aside the Bible, there is evidence that Jesus died.
Right, okay.
Did you hear what I said?
Hold on a second. Okay.
Did you hear what I said?
You said to stay in the subject, yeah?
No, I said
the reason I mentioned the Bible. The reason I mentioned the Bible, because you say, if I'm wrong, tell me.
You said it's hocus pocus what the Quran said. So therefore,
about that verse.
About that verse. That's what you say.
Yes.
Right. Now, since you don't want to accept that one, now let's see if you will accept what the Bible tells
no,
you.
No, we're not talking about the Bible. We're talking about the Quran.
Why?
We're going to subject. Wait, the subject is the
point.
Quran.
He's trying to make a point.
No, he's trying to divert onto the Bible. I know he's tactics.
Oh, because you know the Bible is going to expose you.
This guy had done this before. I don't make the same mistake twice. He cannot defend his faith. He cannot defend Surah 157.
Okay.
So he's trying every You're trying every tactic in the book.
You're right.
Shall
I show you something in the Bible again?
So Surah 157 is a lie.
That your Bible tells you. You have no evidence.
Surah 157 cannot identify who was crucified.
He's not listening. He doesn't want to listen.
We don't know who was crucified.
Yeah,
we don't know.
So why are you letting to talk to me?
Tell the camera who was crucified.
Why you don't want to talk to me?
Tell the camera.
Why you don't want to talk to me?
Because I want you to fight.
All right. He wants me to lie in front of the camera.
Because what you say is going to be a lie.
Let me tell you.
I want you to tell the camera.
You say.
Tell the camera the lie. Tell the camera. Tell the camera the lie.
Allow me to talk to you. Allow me to talk. Right. You said, I'm going by what you just said. You said what the Quran said is hocus pocus. That's what you said. And I said to you, okay, since you don't want to accept that, let's see what the Bible said, because that's what you accept. The Bible is what you accept.
I know what the Bible says.
The Bible says that in the most critical juncture of the life of Jesus,
that's a different subject. That's a different subject.
And forsake
you, see how, ladies and gentlemen, take note. He's changing this subject.
How can it be different subject?
You're changing.
There is no witness.
Let me tell you why. Let me tell you why.
There's no witness to the crucifixion.
He said there is no witness to the crucifixion.
Yes. Show me. Today he's going to show me scripture. The other time he refused to show me scripture, by the way. So today he's going to show me scripture. Go ahead.
Right. Now we're going to deal, and we're going to deal with scripture and only
only scripture.
And that's why when we're dealing with the Quran, we're going to deal only with Quran.
Okay, right. What do you say? Okay. What do you say about what I just said? Okay, what do you say about what I just said? That according to the Bible, right, in the most critical doctrine of the life of Jesus, they all fled and forsake it.
That is the case. I'm not denying that.
Oh, you're not denying that.
Also,
so that means they all forsake
it. No, it doesn't.
There was no witness to it.
Can I answer that?
That's what he means.
First and foremost,
they all forsake it.
Right. Can I answer? First and foremost, that with prophecy, Jesus already.
He said, in the most critical juncture of the life of Jesus,
now, ladies and gentlemen, he keeps repeating the same thing for effect. This is what Muslims do. You keep repeating the same thing for effect. I've got your question, my friend.
We're repeating it so that it gets into your head.
I've got your question.
I'm not repeating it. I give it so you get it in your head.
Okay.
Because it looks like you, it's like a hammer you have to knock in your head for you to understand what you're saying.
Okay, when
that's all.
Tell me when you're finished.
I'll finish.
No, please go. You finish?
No, no. You said, you said we keep repeating. I said, I'll repeat it.
I'm going
to
deal with it.
Because as a hammer, you've got to knock the nail for it to go through.
Right, now
if
I'm
going to
deal with it. I'm going to deal with it.
It don't get into your head.
Deal with it.
Your head is so hard, therefore you need to keep knocking it.
Okay,
the truth.
I'm going
to
deal with your question.
Yeah,
first and foremost, the disciples scattering was a prophecy that Jesus made. Jesus said that this was going to happen. So he was not aware of it. He said that when they attack the sheep, the shepherd will run away. That's what he said.
Right.
So Jesus beforehand, in talking about his crucifixion, said that was going to happen.
Right, so therefore,
you're finished.
Who witnessed it?
Remember I told you.
Therefore, who witnessed it? Thank you.
You see what they're doing again? Repeating the same question for effect and not giving me a chance to answer it. Right. I'll start again. First of all, Jesus prophesied that that was going to happen.
Yeah.
So it didn't take him by surprise. Beforehand, Jesus said that at my mouth. Jesus said what you just said. Jesus said at the most critical hour, you guys are going to let me down.
Yeah.
He said that before it happened. And then it did happen.
Okay.
So don't keep mentioning it like it was a surprise or something that went wrong.
Right.
Jesus knew it was going to happen. He prophesied it and then it happened.
Yeah, but the point was, answer that quickly. The point was, we were trying to establish whether there were witnesses.
That's what I'm getting onto. I'm going to show you an abundance of witnesses.
Okay, go on.
I'm going to show you an abundance
show
of witnesses.
Show me now.
Right.
Stop talking. Show me.
St. John 19. St. John 19.
You are my brother.
Now I'm going to read St. John 19 and I'm going to read quite a bit. I'm going to read from 19. Wherefore they crucified him and two others with him on either side.
Yeah.
one and Jesus in the midst. Yeah. And Pilate wrote a title and put it on the cross.
And
the writing was Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews.
Yeah.
This title then read many of the Jews, for the place where Jesus was crucified was nigh to the city, and it was written in Hebrew and in Greek and Latin. Then said the chief priests of the Jews to Pilate,
what was written in Greek and Latin?
Let me read.
No.
Let scripture speak. Too much talking. Let scripture speak. Right. Right. Then said the chief priests of the Jews, write not the King of the Jews, but that he said, I am the King of the Jews. Right. Pilate answered, what I have written, I have written. Then the soldiers, when they had crucified Jesus, took his garments and made four parts in every shoulder apart. And also unto the without the seam. Right, so they cut him in half. They cut the seam in half, right down the middle. Basically what he's saying.
And who's speaking?
Right, I'm gonna move on.
Who's speaking there?
Johnny's speaking there. Johnny's narrating. Johnny's the narrator. They said therefore among themselves, let us rend it, but cast lots for it, whose it shall be, that the scripture might be fulfilled, which said, they parted my raiment among them, and for my vesture they did cast lots. Now there stood by the cross of Jesus, his mother. Now listen.
Yes.
Now listen.
Yes.
Right.
Listen.
Now listen.
His mother.
Now there stood by the cross of Jesus, his mother, and his mother's sister. Martha, wife of Eliphaz, and Mary Magdalene. So that's three women. That's three women already.
Right.
That's
three women.
So first of all,
I'll read it again.
But you can't get away from the fact that there are witnesses here.
Right. There's no disciples.
We've not gotten there yet, my friend. Don't be so hasty. Okay, that's fine. Right, that's okay. That's four witnesses. Right, no.
Where's Johnny at?
First of all, Mary Magdalene was a disciple.
Where's Paula?
Yeah, he's there.
Where's Paula?
He's so cocky, isn't he? Right, let's carry on reading. Now they stood by the cross of Jesus, his mother, and his mother's sister Mary, wife of Cleopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciple standing by whom he loved, the disciple whom Jesus loved. So there's a guy already, and we know that's John, but let's carry on. Right. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciple standing by whom he loved, he said unto his mother, woman, behold your son. So there's a guy there already. Right, okay. Then said he to the disciple, behold thy mother. And from that hour, that disciple took her unto his home. After this, Jesus, knowing that all things were now accomplished, that the scripture might be fulfilled, said, I thirst. Right. There we go. So three women and one guy, John. That's only one. Let's show you some more. So what we got here, let's
did
be
it say
clear.
It was John?
Let's be clear. No, it is John, but we'll get to that. Let's be clear. But first of all,
But
we know it's John if you do the whole context.
No, we don't know it's John until you read.
No.
And it says.
No, hold on, my friend. This is from someone.
I agree with that one.
That's cool at all. But let's establish something here. Let's establish that we've got some eyewitnesses. Prior to this, you were saying there was none. Let's not try. When you get caught, be honest. You were implying.
My friend, I'm just mentioning.
You were implying that there were not. As my friend, you said there are no witnesses, so therefore you said, show me where they are.
Jesus
and I showed you some witnesses.
Jesus knew it was going to happen. And he told his disciples.
Hold on. Right, so I showed them four witnesses.
Yes.
I showed them four. Right, now let's talk about some more. But that's just four.
Very interesting.
That's just four.
Didn't get that memo.
No.
Let's look at some more.
The reason why
let's look at some more.
He said Mary.
Establish, ladies and gentlemen. We saw three women, eyewitnesses, and John, eyewitnesses, at the foot of Jesus, at the cross. Right, at the foot of Jesus. Eyewitnesses.
And then Mary.
Now let me stop.
Mary Magdalene. Now
let me stop and ask you a question. Let me stop and ask you a question. Where are your eyewitnesses? Where are your eyewitnesses?
My eyewitness is
now tell
the
me.
Word
no,
of
let
Jesus.
Me, let me establish.
Jesus
let me establish.
Jesus
let me establish. Hold on. Let me establish. Let me.
That's
what he's doing, ladies and gentlemen. He's repeating himself again. You see what he's doing? I'm asking you, where are your eyewitnesses to the life of Jesus? Because somebody in the Quran had the audacity to say that Jesus didn't die and they were not there.
Right.
That's a lie. Okay. You know what would happen to Muhammad in the days of Moses? Right. They would crush him to bits with stones.
Yeah,
he's a false prophet.
Okay.
Right.
Jesus said to you in the Bible. Jesus is saying to you in the Bible, on that day, many will come unto me and say, Lord,
my friend, you're not dealing with my issues. My friend, you're not dealing with my issues. Where are you? My friend, depart from me, Lord. I'm asking a question. Where are the Muslims? Where are the Muslims? Where are the Muslims? Eyewitnesses. You need some eyewitnesses.
You
need some eyewitnesses.
Depart from me. I never knew you.
He doesn't have any eyewitnesses. Islam doesn't have any eyewitnesses. Muslims don't have any eyewitnesses. Muhammad is a false prophet. Muhammad is a false prophet.
Day of judgment.
He's a false prophet.
Many
so what I'm saying is this. So what I'm saying, right? My point is, no. It matters. No, it does. It does matter because what the guy done. Let's follow his trail. Let's follow the dishonesty and let's follow the intellectual dishonesty of this guy. Because we've done this before. He asked me for evidence, and then when I give him, first of all, evidence is evidence. It's not a matter about men or women. I know Islam hates women, but that's your problem.
But hold on, one second.
Women are witnesses. No.
We're not talking about women.
Let's go with the evidence.
Yeah. Right. So, the evidence is that I showed you three women and one guy.
One guy.
Yeah.
Right.
There's more. There's more.
But it says.
But let's deal with that.
One second. It says. Yeah. It says he saw his mother.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the disciples, disciples, plural, yeah, that he loves. Yes? Did it not say that?
Yes.
Then it, in the next verse, it went to one disciple.
That's right.
Yes, and then some other scriptures.
Now, what he's trying...
Are you asking me to show you some other scriptures?
No.
So, right, what are you
asking?
We're clear with
what you're saying. Yeah?
Right, okay.
But I'm saying, I think the contention is, yeah, if he made that prediction that the brother said originally to the disciples, now you lot, in my finest hour, are gonna abandon me.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And we know they abandoned him.
And then they came back.
On the way, that's while he was carrying the cross, one of them was standing there saying, they say, hey, you roll with Jesus. No, I don't know.
No, I don't know him.
You're gonna deny me three times.
Yeah.
Cool, no problem.
Yeah.
Yeah, we understand all of this. So that not every disciple would have been at the crucifixion.
I didn't say that. You're bringing in another argument. You're bringing in an argument that I didn't say.
That's what I'm saying.
Let me deal with that now.
Well,
first of all,
disciples,
I'll just repeat what the Bible says.
Let me deal with that now.
I'll repeat what the Bible says.
You created.
So go.
I get you.
Go and define what the Bible says. The Bible says
that.
They all forsake him and fled.
Right. Who?
Let's establish some stuff. That's why you want to wear my
hat. An eyewitness is an eyewitness. Doesn't matter if it's a man or woman. Let's not do this sexist garbage about where the guy. First of all, hold on.
Did I mention woman or man?
No, you seem to suggest. You seem to. Okay, hold on. Okay.
It's you. I never mentioned man or woman.
Let me flesh this out. Once you ask me a question, you ask me the question, where are the witnesses? In a way, you know, the cynical tone in your voice was suggesting that there were none. The cynical tone in your voice. Show me. And then I showed you, and then you're trying to pick it apart.
If you ask
me, do you have an apple? And I take out one apple, and you say, is it only one?
Yeah.
You ask me for an apple, I took out one apple. Now you want two?
Okay.
That's your argument.
Okay.
I've given you an apple.
If you show me one apple, and I say to you, well, earlier you told me you've got no apple.
But I didn't say that.
But there you go.
But that's what I just said.
Right. Jesus said they all forsake
my friend.
So why are you calling me the liar? You should call the Bible the liar.
Let me ask.
Because I was just repeating what the Bible said.
It wasn't my words. My friend. Right. Okay. Right, ladies and gentlemen. First and foremost, Jesus prophesied that the disciples would leave.
Scripture.
Jesus prophesied that the disciples would leave, and they did, and they also came back.
Bible says,
they also
so
came back. For example,
that
I will be.
Send John 8.
So that's
therefore, you.
So let's establish.
You're
not saying anything.
You're
not saying anything.
You're the deceiver.
Right, so let's establish.
You're the deceiver.
We've identified four witnesses. We've identified four witnesses so far.
Four.
There's more.
Only four.
Three
witnesses. You're
only
telling
four.
Me Jesus.
Only four. He hasn't got
listen,
one.
Listen.
Only four.
Listen.
Only four.
Yes.
And you don't have one. With your one witness.
Did he hear that?
Where's your
did
one
he hear
witness?
That? No, hold on a second.
Where is your one witness?
Okay.
No, we want some eyewitnesses from you.
All right, okay.
Who
this
saw
no
my,
smoke
what Muslim? What Muslim saw Muhammad?
Yes.
What Muslim?
Yes.
What Muslim?
My friend. They dragged him from on the streets of Jerusalem.
Right,
you're
doing acting now. Right, Muslims, Islam has no evidence. Islam has no eyewitness evidence. There was no Muslim that saw Jesus. There was no Muslim that saw Jesus.
Am I correct?
See, you're just acting out now.
No, I'm not acting.
You are my friend. Because you're not trying to make him talk. You know, my friend, I'm asking you a simple question. Give me one eyewitness from the Muslim world that saw Jesus. You need an eyewitness. You don't have any.
Listen, but the Muslim we never pretended or told
right.
So we have witness of somebody who saw Jesus. So all we're saying to you is, all we're saying to you is
that God told you.
What we're saying to you is, you did not accept. That I was very fair. I said you are saying, which obviously I understand anyway. You do not accept the version of what the Quran said. I said, all right,
okay.
You don't have to accept it, my brother. You don't have to.
Right.
I'm not forcing you.
And I'm not forcing you.
And that's what
we're trying to establish.
Since
truth.
You don't want to accept what the Quran said, so now,
but
let's
my
see
friend,
what the Bible said.
It's not just about.
I was being fair.
Right, okay.
Because I'm telling you something. The Quran said
what the Bible says.
He wasn't crucified.
Okay, so.
He said no.
It's what okay, right.
We'll go with the Bible.
Let's go with the Bible.
The Bible said they will forsake him and left.
Let's go. No. Right. Let's go
so
with the Bible.
So now it's you. The onus is on you to prove to me wrong.
You said that a million times.
Not
you know.
Me, that, but the Bible.
You said that, but you keep talking.
All right.
You keep talking. Right. Okay. Right. So let's deal with it firstly. First of all, let's get the context. The context of running and way is the fulfillment of Jesus' prophecy. It makes all the difference in the world. If you just say they ran away, it looks like it left Jesus on a hang up. It didn't. He knew it was going to happen. If you just say they ran away, it looks like Jesus was let down. No, I'm finished.
Okay,
my friend, this is not how you have a dialogue. This is not how you have a dialogue. You made a claim. Right. You're trying to say it doesn't matter. I'm saying it I understand what you're saying, but I'm saying you haven't got the context right. It makes all the difference in the world saying that they ran away and understanding that Jesus said they would run away. It's a whole different picture because it looks like Jesus was caught on it. I mean, he wasn't. If he said that something is going to happen, that means it's a part of prophecy.
So you know, that means he was expecting
that mean, yes.
Was he expecting it?
He knew it was going to happen. He was expecting it. Call it
he was
what
expecting
he
it.
He knew.
So why did he complain in the Bible saying they all forsake him and left?
Was it a complaint? See, you see how you're putting words in the Bible?
No,
it's not a complaint.
I'm just saying, if I'm expecting something,
it wasn't a complaint.
If I'm expecting something, why would I turn around
let me answer
and say, oh,
let me answer.
Let
me.
You can know you're going to get sentenced to jail.
Yeah.
And when you're in jail, you can still think, oh, fuck.
There you go. There you go. Common sense. Common sense. Common sense.
Inside of you to cry out and say, this isn't fair.
But brother, do you know why we're mentioning this?
I know.
It's because the Quran says he wasn't killed.
So now let's deal with the Bible. You said you wanted to go to the Bible. You said you wanted to go to the Bible.
You know what I'm saying? So because, look,
my friend.
Look, because the Bible said, let me tell you another thing.
Can I be
the Bible said,
yes, do.
All right. What I'm saying is, let's more stick to the point.
Yeah.
So now the point is, like, you said there was no witnesses, right? You say, I've just shown you four witnesses.
Yeah, and that's only some.
Right. Now, my contention, I see where the problem's coming. The question he's saying is that when he made that prediction, and he knows, yeah, we all agree that he knew what was going to happen.
Yeah.
That's fine. Yeah. The problem is that he's saying, who did he say it to? In your
he said it to them. He said it to the disciples.
To the disciples.
When they attacked the shepherd, the sheep are going to scatter.
Right. So the four witnesses, three of them are not disciples. One is a disciple.
Yeah, but there were others.
So he's correct in what he's saying.
No. There's a couple of stuff here. Let's establish that all 12 eyewitnesses ran. They didn't all return. I'm not saying they all returned. I'm saying some returned. I.e. Simon Peter. Simon Peter ran away and returned immediately. When they brought Jesus into the palace.
It doesn't.
Send John 18. It doesn't. Send John 18. You have to read that.
I think you know what you should have done?
You should take notes.
Read on. No. Read on because.
It's hard to do that.
Okay. It was.
Okay. It's hard to do that in this thingy. But you know, but because of shortage of time, maybe. Sometimes. But this is going to be online, so you can check it out. So let me give the verse to be clear, so that when this goes up on 8. Send John 18. We see that Simon Peter has returned. Read St. John 18 and read it in context. So after he ran away, Simon Peter returns. When they brought Jesus into the palace, Simon Peter was there hiding and warming himself at the fire, it says. So he's watching them trying Jesus. After he ran off, he sneaked back, yeah, and he was watching them warming himself at the fire, St. John 18. And St. John 19 gives us four eyewitnesses. And 1 Peter 4 gives us more eyewitnesses. Simon Peter said, I was an eyewitness of the sufferings of Christ. Acts chapter 10 and Acts chapter 19 and Acts chapter 2 said that we are witnesses of these things. that which you have seen and heard, this is what they keep saying, those things which you have seen and heard, we are telling you them. We were eyewitnesses. God caused us to be eyewitnesses. He showed us, Jesus is saying, I'm paraphrasing, after the resurrection. Not to all people, but to those who God has specially selected beforehand. So, that's what it says in Acts.
So break that down, that is how many people now?
Well, I've got six already. Yeah, why we can't know? I've got six, but the four women and John,
I want to know how many of the disciples.
Why? No, but I want to know why.
Yeah, what's the gun?
No, it makes sense.
No, because why does it make sense?
Yeah, why?
No, because
why not?
It was
because,
the number.
Because it's not. Because it's not stipulated that these are the witnesses that's going to prove everything to be true.
Yeah,
no.
So you're making up a question.
That's what happens. We've established eyewitnesses. Let's be clear here, for the sake of some clarity.
As I say, you're saying now your contention is altogether there are six eyewitnesses.
No, I didn't say that. No, see, that's why I'm not going to answer that because you're trying to pin me down. No, what I'm saying is, look, St. John, 1 Corinthians 15 said that all the disciples, let's be clear. 1 Corinthians 15, Paul mentions all of the 12 disciples. He said all of the 12 disciples saw Jesus at the resurrection. And then I saw him. That's what he said. So that's 13 of them. 12 and Paul himself 13. And then he said there was...
Hold on,
let's be clear. Let's not jump.
Paul, did you say?
I'm not going there. Right. You will not take me off track.
The point is this. New Testament.
I have
is that New Testament?
So check this out now. Let's be clear here now, yeah?
Saul.
This guy,
the killer,
this guy, this guy that doesn't have one eyewitness,
you can take their account.
Right, let's finish. Paul said that the 12 disciples were eyewitnesses, and then he said, I was the eyewitness. He said, I was the eyewitness
of
13
of Christ.
And then Paul said there was 500 others. So that's 513. My friend.
I rock with him. Once you go, once you go with Paul.
We'll deal with Paul later. But you know, don't throw the argument. I tell you why
that's in the brain. A man who wasn't there.
Wait a minute.
Are you saying he was there?
You see what you do?
You said he's 13.
Do you know who's Simon?
I'm there.
My friend.
I was there. I saw Christ.
Stop, that's a serious lie.
Blasphemy.
Do you know Simon?
Blasphemy, man.
Do you know Simon? Okay. Right, they're messing around now. I'm being serious.
No.
Right.
I'm being serious.
No, I'm stopping now. Right. This is for people to be educated about the truth.
Was he there?
There are 513 eyewitnesses.
Saul there.
Yes. Okay, can I carry on now? He was there. Right, 1 Corinthians 15. Paul mentions all 12. He mentioned the 12. And he says, I too were there. That's 13. And then he talks about... And then he talks about another 500.
What?
That's 513 eyewitnesses. 513 eyewitnesses.
And no one did it.
The 12 names.
The 12 disciples.
Give me one of the names.
Simon Peter.
Second name.
John the Beloved. Saul of Tarsus.
Oh no, he's giving you...
Matthew. Mary Magdalene. Martha. Right, so 13 eyewitnesses and then another 500. 500, ladies and gentlemen. 513 eyewitnesses. Do you know how many hours that is in court? As a matter of fact, the guy called Josh McDowell summed it up to say that each eyewitness would get about six hours in court.
Are you standing?
They would get court time.
So,
no, what I'm saying is, I've got 500 eyewitnesses. This guy's fighting me and he hasn't given me one.
No, but I'm saying...
So check this, yeah.
Could you really take Paul's account, though?
Yes, you can take Paul's account.
You cannot take Paul's account.
Why not? Why not? Tell me why.
People need to stop.
No, defend yourself.
This tomfoolery.
Tell me why. Go on.
If you know the scriptures.
What do you know about Paul?
I study the scriptures.
Okay.
You get me? I study the scriptures very well.
Thank you.
You get me?
Tell me what you know about Paul.
7, 8, 9 Bibles in
my friend. My friend. That doesn't mean nothing.
Blah, blah, blah.
My friend.
But anyway, I grew up in it. You get me? I grew up in it. You can't beat that. You know what I'm saying? I went Sunday school.
My friend, you all went to Sunday school.
But I'm telling you,
my friend.
I'm telling you.
Tell me what you know.
I'm telling you.
Tell me what you know.
Saul.
Tell me what you.
My friend.
Can I?
A man who wanted to be a Roman. Yeah.
Exactly.
His career. Yeah.
Confirming the faith.
As a Sephardic. You get what I'm saying? As a I'm sorry. Not a Sephardic.
Okay.
He was basically a Jewish policeman who persecuted Christians.
No, no, Paul.
Yes,
Paul was a Sanhedrin.
He was a killer.
Thank you, thank Sanhedrin. You, thank you, thank you.
He was a Sanhedrin.
Now you're telling me this Sanhedrin's word?
Yes. Yes, that's what I'm telling
law.
You. And what I'm saying
so
is, no, no, I'm saying that Jesus' word is law.
He's a self-proclaimed.
I said Jesus'
the word is
law. Now you're trying to distract my friend. You're trying to
Christ proclaim.
I'm still waiting for
I want
one
Christ proclaim.
I need one witness from you who saw Jesus.
If Christ says, this is the guy, I'm rocking with him.
But Paul also had a revelation.
Right. So ladies and gentlemen, Islam has no eyewitnesses. The Christian faith has 513 eyewitnesses alone. And not only that, today people are still seeing Jesus. People are still seeing Jesus today.
What's going on?
Jesus is still revealing himself to people today. So let's be clear. 513 eyewitnesses.
Has he revealed himself to you?
Zero. My friend, zero. 513 eyewitnesses to zero witnesses from you.
For what?
Right. To the resurrection and the life of Jesus.
Zero witnesses.
Right. You have none. Not one. You have a man that said he went in a cave.
Yeah.
Now, not one did Allah go to a second part of the confirm army.
But,
not once.
But I told you. I told you what the what Jesus said.
After
Jesus
the cave.
Said, Jesus said,
my friend,
nobody witnessed it.
After the cave. After Muhammad came
out.
One second. After Muhammad's cave. After Muhammad's cave.
There were only four.
Witnesses.
After Muhammad's. No, there weren't only four.
That's it.
No, there's four. Right. After Muhammad got his revelation. Allah did it one time, not one time.
My friend, my friend, was Matthew there?
No, he doesn't. No, he doesn't. Yeah, exactly.
Muslims
are clutching us.
No, no, no. It's why Christ gave a proclamation.
You see what you tried to do?
About what's going to happen to my disciples. Yes.
No, my friend,
and only one of them witnessed it.
My friend, you don't.
Am I not right?
You don't set the criteria.
Most of them did not. You get me? Most of them fled and did not see
that. No, he tried to give human logic. You're trying to give human logic.
With the police,
my friend, you don't set the criteria
for them as well.
You don't set the criteria, my friend.
Is it something you can just turn
my
up
friend.
And just be there? Yeah,
my
Jesus,
friend. My friend.
No,
you don't set the criteria. Is what you're trying to do?
Any depiction
you're
of
trying
that
to set
story
the criteria.
Shows
he does not set the criteria. The Bible set the criteria.
I'm saying,
and the criteria that the Bible has set is 539. I see what you tried
to
do. That's why you wanted me. You wanted me to count so you could say there's only six. But I can retaliate. Where was your one?
Our retaliation. We haven't even proved it.
Where was your one?
You haven't proved it.
We've got 530 eyewitnesses.
He hasn't proved
we've got
six.
500.
What we have.
I'm not proving six. I'm proving 513.
No, you haven't proved that.
513 eyewitnesses. 513 eyewitnesses to the life of Jesus. And Islam hadn't come up with one. So in that context that we're talking about, Muhammad got a revelation in a cave. That revelation was never confirmed. Not once did the angel Gabriel go to someone else and confirm Muhammad's revelation. So what I'm saying is, Islam had no eyewitness evidence. None. Not one drop. Not even for Muhammad. Muhammad thought he was demon possessed, as a matter of fact.
Yes.
And look at the context of this. His wife presumed. She said, this must be. His wife said, the spirit that spoke to Moses. That's an assumption. We need to establish.
Yes.
She assumed that it must be the spirit. That's no foundation at all. So we have five. So the Christian faith is based on eyewitness evidence. The eyewitnesses that were there that hanged around with Jesus. They knew. If they got it wrong, then let's forget the rest.
And it's Paul.
Let's all go home like Paul said.
Are you agreeing that Paul is one of those eyewitnesses?
Yes, Paul said he's one of those witnesses. Paul said that.
Is he a disciple of Christ?
No. Let's do what you asked.
No, is he a disciple of Christ?
Yes, he is.
He became a disciple.
He's an apostle.
Is he a disciple of
Christ? He became one and he's an apostle, yes.
He came after Christ died, yeah?
What do you mean after? He's a contemporary. Do you know
after
that?
Christ
you
died,
do
yeah.
know that Paul was a
not in
my friend. You do know that
it's
Paul
12 disciples, yes?
You do know that Paul
and
was
Paul is not one of them, yes?
You do know that Paul was.
Stop play pimping. Come on. Be
can
real,
I,
man.
Can I finish?
No, you've
can
got
I finish?
You're preaching.
Can I finish?
Yeah, I'm here to teach.
Let's hear the teaching.
And the Gospels and Acts,
And
that's the whole Bible.
Sorry, yeah, well,
okay, that's
most of it. Most of it. That Paul stuff, bro, we can't rock with that, bro.
We can. So tell us why we can't.
Tell us why we can't.
You can't.
Tell us why.
Tell us why.
One, because of the person's character. One, because of the timeline that the individual saying he's existing. Do you get what I'm saying? He's not existing in
you
the time.
You do know that
he came after the
time. Wait a minute, my friend.
No, this is not finished. The real facts of the matter is the real facts of the matter. Any Bible historian studies these things and knows where Paul comes in. Do you know what I'm saying?
Do you know the names of these
He does not come in
do you know the names of these
scholars? Of Christ.
My friend, I've got to ask you one thing. Do you know the names of these scholars that agree with you?
But what does that mean?
No, we haven't.
What does that mean? He doesn't come at the time of Christ, so what does that mean?
So he is not a disciple.
Why? Who says that? Who says that?
That message.
Who says that?
That message that was given to
the disciples. You're talking too much.
You see the human wisdom?
No, you see the human wisdom?
No, I want scripture, my friend.
Can I talk, man?
You said you brought
Let him talk. Let him talk.
When he gave that.
Let him talk, man. Because I want to know where he's going with this.
When he gave that revelation, it's clear to see, bro. He gave it to his disciples, which Paul was not one of them. You get me? Paul heard of this story later on at a later time.
Yeah,
and new people.
Wait, let me talk.
New people and individuals like Christ's son. But we don't want to go there because you're going to get into
stick with the Paul, man. We don't know
Right. So, you're not in the time of Christ. Let's get that straight. You get what I'm saying? This Paul, this one who rode on a donkey and had this revelation on the road to Damascus.
You know when Paul
and said he saw Jesus.
You know when
Jesus gave him his authority. Now, that. We can question, bro.
You see how
we have
good,
to question.
Yeah, thank you.
We have to question one. Yeah. Then when you add the person's career and what they're trying to aspire to, letter to the Corinthians.
Nah, we can't think like you.
Yeah.
No, that's crazy.
He's writing letters. Hold on one second. One second. He's writing letters. He's writing letters.
Too human. You know what I mean?
The Romans.
Too human.
The Romans.
No scripture.
Too human.
No, you said you believe in scripture.
His works. Yeah. Are letters to the Corinthians, letters to the Romans, letters to any other civilization around that time, right? Mainly the Romans. Because he wants to be a Roman.
No.
You understand?
No.
Now let him finish!
I'm telling you.
He's making this up. Let's hear how he makes it up. It's good to watch.
Remember.
It's good to watch.
He's an Asker.
But he won't work here, brother. May I tell you that?
You hear me? Right?
Go on.
No. So, he is not a Jew. Yeah. He is from. He's a Pharisee. These men,
that we're talking about,
who are calling themselves Jews at the time, are Jebusites because they're from the descendants of Jebus. You get what I'm saying?
Wow.
So now something has crossed over. Oh no, wait. Now things have crossed over. Jebus now has become Judah.
Jesus, Mary, you understand? Joseph, man.
And people are claiming other people's identity. It's a fact. We know these Jews, these so-called Ashkenazims, are not the man.
How do we get from where you are to where you are?
We're all over the place, man.
My friend, can I ask you a question?
All over the place.
My friend, can I ask you a question? You're not, your argument is not consistent.
What do you mean? It's not an argument. It's just based on fact.
You're
Paul is an agent for the Roman government.
Give me some historical. He was. Give me some historical evidence.
Oh, see.
He was. He was that.
He
Why don't you talk about what Paul is, what he was, and then what he is?
He was.
You see what you're doing?
You're going to stand on this guy. You're going to stand on Paul. When you start to hear all the things about Paul,
no,
you're still going to stand on
it. I already stand on Paul.
You haven't shown me scripture.
So all the things I said was correct.
Not one.
He just said, oh, now he doesn't do that no more.
Yeah, but you haven't said anything. You haven't said anything.
You said you believe in scripture, but you haven't used any.
You haven't said anything.
You said you believe in scripture, but you've used none.
So
I'm listening to you.
I have to.
Well, for this point, yeah.
But I'm explaining things that
But you're saying it's historical fact. Where are the facts?
Well, I'm explaining things that are in the scripture, am I not? Man's career is fully
attained. Paul did not want to be a Roman. Where is that in scripture?
Yeah, where is that?
Where? Right. Come, let's be specific.
Of course it must be in the Bible. You get me?
It must be. Do you know it is or are you assuming it is?
Bro.
The only thing is he controls.
It's like,
you see the reasoning?
Who controls the whole problem?
No, my friend, I'm asking you a question.
Who put these men like Herod. Yeah, and them in the position they were.
You see what you're doing? That's Paul say. That's Paul say.
That's true.
This is not scripture. You claim that it's scripture, my friend.
Because the overall is wrong.
You see the human intellect now. You see that.
Herod was an agent of the Romans.
No, I'm not arguing with that. Okay, I'm a couple of stuff. Show me where Paul wanted to be a Roman. Show me where. How did you even get to where you are? It's confusing. By the way, show me where. You just said your starting point before.
Okay, wait. So if Paul is the bad one, that means Paul interjected and changed the course of wherever it was going, right? So where should it have gone?
Yeah.
It should have stayed with what it was, at least. If it's the disciples' account, we can accept that. Because at least you can say, all right, they rolled with Jesus. You get what I'm saying? Even if they weren't eyewitnesses or they were eyewitnesses, we can still take that more than anyone else.
But tell me this.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but aren't these...
Okay. Not a guy.
No, Anthony, the problem is, Anthony, why are we dealing with Paul? Why don't we deal with the other eyewitnesses?
No, because
got, people always
say... He wrote the majority of the New Testament.
No. Not true.
What do you mean?
First and foremost,
what do you mean? Once you take out what he wrote, what's left?
Let's get things in historical context.
Only Revelation.
We have the Gospels first before Paul.
Come on.
We have the Gospels first. Four Gospels.
So what if some people...
No, not European name.
I want to
don't
know.
Be ignorant.
That's why I call him by his
don't
real name.
So I want to
Saul.
Know.
Right. That's why I called him by his real name, Saul.
Yeah, we have the four Gospels. Yeah,
I know.
Let's establish some stuff, yeah? We have the four Gospels before Paul, yeah?
I just want to say something before you start.
They're only canonical.
I want to really go into something before you start.
Go.
Because you know what? Let's go into Acts to answer his question. Because he made a statement that Paul was dealing with only the Romans.
Yeah.
And all this. But we know our people are already scattered among all these nations.
Yes.
And Paul was mainly addressing and speaking and having a dialogue and bringing them back
to the Hebrews
and telling them that they were Hebrews.
Mm.
So he wasn't dealing with Romans like just the people
and even
of
the
establishment.
People that
was
in, yeah.
But the scriptures say.
And even the people in Rome. They were Hebrews.
So Acts. Yeah.
Which one
Acts,
is it?
You can
read him.
Okay, yeah. I'll read. Which one is it?
Acts 11, first Acts 18, verse 5.
But when Silas and Timothy came down from Macedonia,
yeah.
Paul began devoting himself completely to the word,
yeah.
solemnly testifying to the Jews that Jesus was.
So was
Amen.
Jews,
Amen. Amen.
And not only that,
Amen.
Just go into Acts 11, verse 19.
Yeah, sure. Go ahead, man. Yeah,
Acts 11, verse 19.
Yeah.
So which one is it?
Hold on.
Is
wait.
That or is it
no,
Revelation?
Hold on.
Which one caused the change?
Read.
So then those who were scattered because of the persecution that occurred in connection with Stephen made their way to Phoenicia, Cyprus and Antioch, speaking words to no one except the Jews alone.
They never dealt with no other nation, it was only the Jews.
All right, okay.
Now my point.
The Bible is right.
Sounds good.
I see what you're
saying. Sounds cute.
Wait. I want to hear you.
Sounds cute.
Because you sound so contemporary.
No.
You do, bro.
The reality is, I never said only
the
Romans.
Jesus only came for the
Hebrews. Hold on.
Hold on.
I never said only the Romans one.
You're not saying that.
Because as I said, if I say the Corinthians.
The man's talking.
All the papers that Paul writes here, are two these different nations. That's what I said.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I don't know where you're
going. What do you mean nations? Wait. What do you mean
nations? Nations, community.
To the Jews.
That's it.
But no, community, not nations.
Like he's a king.
Yeah. Right. My friend. Can I just correct
him? The letter to the Romans.
Yeah.
Yeah, who was that?
Yeah, hold on.
Yeah, can I just correct
Hold on, hold on.
Who
can
was
I
that
just,
to?
Can I
yeah,
just
it was the Romans.
It was to the Romans.
Yeah, that's what Romans.
Who leads the Romans?
No, wait a minute. Do you know
a community?
No, wait. No, wait.
Brother.
No, wait.
Bro, you lost it.
You know, don't even go nowhere.
You lost it, bro. You lost it.
Let me ask you.
Listen why it works. No, listen why it works. Listen why it works.
Let me ask
why it works.
You want
because
you know what?
Did Romans?
Wait, hold on. Hold on. Let me ask you a
did
question.
Did Romans become Christians?
Let me ask one question.
That's a very good question.
Did Romans become Christians?
Do we have Nigerians
without
who are British citizens?
That's yes. Right.
Hold on. Do we have Nigerians who are British
yes.
citizens?
Yes.
So if I come to Britain addressing to the British people who are Nigerians,
thank you very much. That's what, so what he's saying is that even though the letter
he
is written to the Romans,
he
they
was
were
the, just
in that
Hebrews,
Roman province. Don't think they were all Caucasians.
No. You know what?
That's
you have to check
thinking.
What you're saying because
they,
some,
I understand
you're not
you.
Coming.
You're what you think?
Yeah. You're just you're not coming
point.
Properly. Trust
hold
me.
You're
not saying you're wrong here.
The average Hebrew, reading Anyway, reading text.
Yeah.
Is that what you're saying?
No,
so,
what,
like a general letter. This is why the stupidity of some people. Yeah, it can only go to the authority.
Let me explain what I'm saying. Can I explain what I'm saying?
Do you understand? Does that make sense to you?
Yes, but can
even if it's Jews,
you
in that thing, it's going to be the higher Sephardics and the thing.
According to the scripture, they were dealing.
And who put them there?
Secretly.
The Romans.
Okay, hold on. Let me ask.
They controlled the whole region. You wouldn't even be talking about Pontius Pilate.
Hold on.
If that was not a point.
One second.
You know what I'm saying? He comes to check.
So what nationality was born?
No, stop it.
What nationality?
Yeah, what nationality was born?
He is from from they are the descendants of Jebus.
Okay.
Yeah,
he was born.
What's the evidence?
Brother, don't worry, I asked the question.
The Bible.
Because hold on, he was born in Cilicia, yeah? So later on, let's say in history, in the beginning, Moses or people called Musa or whatever. In the beginning, what nationality that he thought he was? He thought he was an Egyptian. But it got to a point in time, he realized that he wasn't an Egyptian. He realized that he was an Israelite. The same thing happened with Apostle Paul. Paul thought he was a Roman, persecuting what? The Christians. When they
had Roman citizenship.
Yeah.
I'm done.
That's what I'm saying.
Absolutely.
So he thought he was a Roman. Man. Yeah. But
oh, you want to do your belt now?
He was an Israelite.
Yes.
So was I right or was I right?
About what?
And him wanting to be a Roman. He just explained it.
The Israelites
straight up
were the only people.
Oh,
they were classified as Christians.
Yes.
They were the anointed ones.
Yes.
So that's why he was persecuting the Christians.
I don't understand you, bro. I don't understand you, bro. I don't.
Absolutely.
I
mean,
to be a Roman. Thank you. Thank you.
Why are they both?
He wanted to be a Roman.
No, I'm just saying.
He's explaining
that. Whoa.
Yes.
Paul tells us we're
Thank you.
Paul says I'm a
Roman.
No, wait a minute.
No.
Let's get some context.
No,
Paul was a Pharisee at first, and he didn't like the Christians. He was a CIA agent to start with. He was a bounty hunter. Call him what you want.
Boss.
But then he changed.
You know what? The reason why, you know, all the forces, you don't have to do this.
I will.
But and everybody was telling me, agent the same thing. Because he was even going to be a pharaoh.
But you know what this guy
did? But later on, he wasn't an Egyptian.
He's a convicted.
So it's the same thing with Apostle Paul.
But what this guy
had a Roman citizenship.
You know what you're doing? You're trying to
realize.
Oh, no, you're not sure. You have After all this, you have determined where he's sitting.
It's just like now. We have a criminal in Jamaica, right?
Yeah. Moses was a criminal in Kemet. He committed murder and had to flee.
Right, so Paul, so what this guy doing, he's trying to hold Paul to his past without talking about Paul's future. You're doing what the police do. So at one time, because Paul was a CIA operative, he was that, and then afterwards he changed. So your argument is only tightening my faith. Because you're talking about a guy who was a scum of the earth, who was persecuting Christians, who now changed his mind.
That's where I stopped. When you say scum of the earth, he stopped working for the CIA and he started working for God.
That's what he did.
Scum of the earth that changed.
Yeah, he was. He was
the scum of the earth that changed.
Paul said this himself.
He killed Christians.
Paul said this.
He did all these things.
Yes.
And then he had to change.
Yes. That's what God does.
A Roman.
So what's the testimony?
He wanted to become.
The
Roman
testimony is that God changed his life.
Get that guy. He's
yeah,
a fake.
That's the testimony.
He's a fake.
The testimony.
Yeah. I challenge them. You hear me?
The testimony is that God changes lives. And he was an apostle. And he was an apostle. So do you want to sign up and give him some money?
Okay. No one rates Paul.
Right.
Yeah.
So now.
Establish that. No one rates Paul.
So we've established.
And anyone who rates Paul, just like he said, is an agent. You get what I'm saying?
My
he's
friend,
an agent
I still ask
and the
you,
scum
though.
Of the earth.
I want to ask
he
you,
said
though.
That.
Not my
me.
Friend. Can
really?
I ask you, though?
Paul is a scum of the earth.
Where are you coming?
But he's reformed
now. No, Paul said
yeah.
that. No,
who
Paul
reformed
said
him?
Paul.
Christ?
God.
No.
Yes, Christ.
No,
yes.
We're done.
Yes.
Yes.
You're asking my question again.
No.
Christ reformed him. He said that God has forgiven me because I did it ignorantly in unbelief. That's what he said. I was ignorant. And I was arrogant. And I thought I had
a but you're not giving me a reason, bro. Give me a reason why you don't like Paul. You're not giving me nothing.
Well, he doesn't know.
They've given you bait. So when you watch it later, you'll see that everybody gave an account of Paul. That was negative. And now,
no.
because he's become
and now,
a Christian,
no. Let's be clear.
Okay. No, you've got it wrong.
A man's Paul said Paul said that it's Jesus. Paul said that it's Jesus that changed him.
Tell me why, bro. Divinity.
He doesn't know. He doesn't know. He doesn't even have an argument anymore. It was Paul that said, I persecuted the church of God and I tried to waste it. But because God, who called me in my mother's womb before I was even born, He changed me. That's what He said. Let's see if we can find it. That's what I'm saying. So this Paul, so let's be clear. I'm not saying Paul was a scum. Paul said he was a scum before he met Jesus. He said that I converted, he said that I persecuted the church of God and I wasted it. But now God has called me, who knew me before I was in my mother's womb. And he had his broken matic experience, and God called him. And that the only time he stopped arresting Christians is when Jesus arrested him.
Amen.
Jesus arrested Paul on the road to Damascus. And that's when he changed. And it's been quite clear. Jesus sent Barnabas to him and said that he's a chosen vessel. My friend, are you hearing me? Jesus, are you hearing me, my friend? My friend. My friend, sir, are you hearing me? God, Jesus, said that Paul is a chosen vessel. Paul is a chosen vessel. So get it right. By God. Are you hearing me, my friend? So get it right. You were chosen by God.
Chosen by God.
It should just stop.
He's passed, my friend, but it doesn't work. Because once God changes the man, he changed. Doesn't matter what you think, doesn't matter what you say, doesn't matter what you do. It matters what Scripture says.